From the News Channel 5 Network, this is Inside Politics.
Hello, everyone. I'm News Channel 5's political analyst, Pat Nolan. Welcome to Inside Politics. The 110th Tennessee General Assembly is over. Lawmakers adjourned sine die late Wednesday night. What's the legacy of this second session or year of the 110th General Assembly, which was also Governor Bill Haslam's last one? We've asked Debra Maggart of the CenterPoint LLC Government Relations Group and Joe Ebert of the TENNESEAN to join us to share their thoughts on the subject. Well, guys, what they call Hell Week on the Hill is over. You could see it coming, Joel, because they started fighting among themselves, the House and the Senate in particular.
They did, yeah. I mean, we thought the legislature was going to wrap up this week, but, you know, what started out as lobbing bombs at each other from the opposite chamber on Wednesday morning turned kind of ugly midway through the day when all of a sudden we heard about, the House's belief that the fix on TN Ready, the snafu of education testing, kind of erupted and caused, you know, an even greater divide between the chambers.
But Debra, it's always something. You used to serve in one of those bodies. You were in the House. Is this sort of a rite of passage every year? The lawmakers have to fight with each other before they go home, and it's always some random issue.
Well, you could say that, but I think the Tennessee Ready thing happening, that really, really threw a kink in the works. And so, you know, they had a lot of parents, unhappy teachers, and unhappy principals calling them. So they wanted to get that straight.
Did the legislature make it okay by basically holding the teachers and the students harmless on this, or is this an issue that's still going to bubble up even next year with a new governor and a new legislature?
I mean, it wouldn't shock me if it comes up again next year, but no, for now, teachers, students, schools, nobody will be accountable in a negative sense based off of what happened with this test.
And Debra, the education commissioner, is okay even though this is at least the third year there's been a problem with this testing?
Well, I think that she's trying very hard to make this work out for everybody, and you know, she can't control this particular vendor, so you know, they are going to have to figure out what they're going to do about it though, because it just isn't working out like everybody hopes.
So this is an issue sitting on the desk of the new governor when he or she takes office in January, and the legislature when they come
sure.
back. I mean, it'll at least be bubbling there. We won't be testing in January, but we will be testing when they come back before they finish the session next year.
Mm-hmm. Well, and I think it should be pointed out that at least this latest snafu was what they're arguing is part of a hacking, effort. So the last couple have been, you know, isolated. This one seems to be a larger issue that was really kind of unforeseen by anybody.
There didn't seem to be a large issue before this legislature, like last year when they did the gas tax and cutting other taxes and the transportation plan. Did that sort of put the legislature focusing on a lot of hot button issues instead of something that was big because the governor didn't have something and the lawmakers didn't have one right before him that really made a big difference this year?
Well, I thought the legislature was kind of low key all year until the very end. You know, we didn't have a big fight over anything like, you know, they had that Bible bill that time. That was a big fight at the end, 2 years in a row. We didn't have, I didn't think, some big, huge thing until the Tennessee Ready thing happened, and that just happened. Timing, it just happened at the end.
Was that because it was the end of the term, for this governor, end of the term for a lot of the leaders in the legislature? Did that also have a difference in a lot of lawmakers retiring or going to run for other local offices as well?
Yeah, I mean, I think the governor's proposals, for the most part, throughout his administration, the heavy lifting was done. So, you know, the things he introduced this year, whether it was opioids, whether it was, you know, reforming the University of Tennessee board, those were kind of seen as smaller issues, not quite like the gas tax, not quite like Tennessee Promise, that sort of thing. So
there was a change of scenery this year for lawmakers. They went into the new renovated Cordell Hall building. You've had a chance to be there for the entire session for one time. What changes did that make, Debra, for doing your job to get to lawmakers? Was it harder, easier, better than it was before,
well,
or
worse? It's a beautiful building, and they did a fantastic job taking something that we had and making it better. But it is harder. It's a little harder to see people because everyone's on so many floors. You know, before you could see everybody on that one floor down there at the plaza. So it is a little harder to see everybody every day.
And Joel, reporters have that problem too because it's not as easy. If you want to find somebody, it's easier not to be found.
There's a couple of corridors that people can escape. And I think the other thing for us as a press corps, we in the old plaza were right outside of a couple committee rooms. So you would hear if there was a big hubbub in the hallway. We are so far removed. We're on the first floor of the new building, and the second floor is where the committee rooms are. So if something's going on the second floor in the halls, we wouldn't really know unless you're really keeping an eye out.
So you needed a roster this year. You need a map this year to find your way around. Next year you're going to need a roster card because there are going to be a lot, so many new people. I mean, we're having a record turnover, at least in the House, and maybe combined in both chambers.
Yeah. I mean, we're going to have a whole new class of freshmen. We're going to have new speaker in the House. We'll likely have a new majority leader. Mm-hmm. It's going to look completely different than last couple of years have been.
But in terms of the balance of power, Debra, do you see any major change? A Republican supermajority has controlled both houses. Do you see that contracting in any major way? The Democrats going to make the inroads? They're looking for a big blue wave nationally. Is that going to happen here?
Definitely the Democrats are energized. I know that the Republican Party is taking it very seriously. I do think there could be a few seats in play. I'm going to hope for the best that everyone comes or retains a Republican member. But I do think that there's an opportunity there for the Democrats this time. Now, a poll came out yesterday somewhere that, you know, everyone in Tennessee still loves Donald Trump. So, you know, we'll have to see how that plays out in November. But I do think the Democrats have an opportunity maybe at two seats, perhaps.
Which won't take down the majority very much.
No, not at all.
Joel, one of the reasons it may be a couple of years before the Democrats get any traction is the Republicans drew these lines about 10 years ago, mm-hmm. as the Democrats did in the past. This next legislature will not do that. The next after that will. But until those lines are changed, if they are changed much, and unless there's a different party with a little bit more control, you're probably not going to see a lot of change in that because the Republicans drew those lines to favor themselves, and that's probably what's going to happen.
I think that's right. I mean, I think it's possible that Democrats pick up a few seats that are currently held by Republicans, but, you know, it looks like there could be some Democratic losses, whether that's Craig Fitzhugh's seat, you know, that's mm-hmm. one that Republicans are eyeing, or a couple of other retiring members, whether maybe Joe Pitts' seat.
There'll be a new Speaker of the House because Beth Harwell is running for governor and giving up her House seat. The fight for that has already begun, mm-hmm. right? Who are the major contenders, David?
Well, Glenn Cassada, Gerald McCormick, Curtis Johnson, and there has been some talk about David Hawk as mm-hmm. well. So if I had to pick who was going to win today, I would say it would be Glenn, because Glenn has made it his business ever since he got there in 2002 or 2001. I think he got there in an off year. To cultivate people to run for office and to build this majority. And so he always has an advantage, in my view, because he raises money and he helps people in their campaign. So he's I know him. He's already figured out, you know, those folks. So he's going to have those votes.
Debra Maggart of CivicPoint LLC, Government Relations Group, and Joel Ebert from TENNESEAN, our guest on Inside Policy. We're talking about the aftermath of the 110th Tennessee General Assembly. They adjourned on Wednesday. Sine died, which means for good. Back to continue our conversation about what they did in the last session after this break. This is-